start with the fifth module. In the fifth module, we start with the interfacing part. In the interfacing part, the first one is the stepper motor. So stepper motor, it is a device that will translate the electrical energy into the mechanical energy. You are going to apply the current or the electrical energy. That electrical energy will be converted in terms of the mechanical movement. And the stepper motor, it will rotate in terms of steps. Whereas in case of the DC motor, a continuous rotation is observed. So that is the difference between the stepper motor and the DC motor. And this is the internal architecture of this stepper motor. And this stepper motor, it usually consists of the one rotor and four stators. The rotor will be in the movement, whereas the stator will be in the fixed position. And the stepper motor consists of a four stator windings, and these stator windings, they are paired with the center tap common. And the center tapping allows the change of the current direction in each of the two coils whenever the winding is grounded, so thereby resulting in the polarity change of the stator. And the stepper motor, it rotates in a fixed repeatable movement. And this repeatable fixed movement, it is possible because of the basic magnetic theory. And this basic magnetic theory states that like poles will repel, whereas unlike poles will attract each other. And the direction of this rotation of the stepper motor, that is mainly controlled by this stator poles. And the stator poles, they are determined by the current sent through the wire form. As the direction of the current is changed, the polarity is also changed, resulting in the reverse rotation of the stepper motor. So this table indicates that it is a normal four step sequence in which you are going to activate the two coils at a time. So when you want to rotate the stepper motor in the clockwise direction, the first sequence is 1001. After that, this sequence will be rotated to the right side. So the next sequence is 1100, the next sequence is 0110, so next sequence is 0011. So when you want the stepper motor to rotate in the clockwise direction, this is the sequence. So when you want the stepper motor to rotate in the anti-clockwise direction, the first sequence will remain same, 1001. So this sequence will be rotated to the left side. So the next sequence will be 0011, the next sequence is 0110, the next sequence is 1100. So next, we'll define some of the terms related to this stepper motor. The first one is step angle. The step angle, it is defined as the, so when you apply the single step or when you apply the one clock pulse, for that one clock pulse, what is the minimum degree of rotation covered by the stepper motor for single step? So that you are going to call it as step angle. So next is the steps per revolution. So in order to have the 360 degree complete rotation, so how many number of steps you are going to apply? What is the total number of steps you are going to require? What is the total number of steps required by the stepper motor? So in order to have the complete one rotation, that you are going to call it as a steps per revolution. So the second table, it indicates the stepper motor step angle. So we have the stepper motor with a different step angle. The first one is 0.72. So if the stepper motor, if it is having a step angle of 0.72 means, so in order to make a complete 360 degree rotation, so you require the totally 500 steps. How it is calculated is 360 degree divided by the 0.72. That will be equivalent to the 500. In a similar way, you want to calculate other things. So next is the 8051 microcontroller connection to this stepper motor. How you are going to interface this unipolar stepper motor to this 8051? So when you are interfacing this 8051 to the stepper motor, so you are going to make use of the driver IC. The driver IC, what you have used is ULN2003. So this, why you require this driver IC means, it is used to drive the current of the stepper motor, as it requires a current more than of the 60 milliampere. And here you are going to make use of the, you are going to interface the 6 wires of this unipolar stepper motor to this 8051 controller. Among the 6 wires, the 2 wires of the stepper motor will be connected to the plus 5 volt. Remaining 4 wires, they are interconnected to this, they are interconnected using the port 1 through this ULN2003. So you don't have the in detail explanation for this interfacing connection, just you need to know the connection of this 8051 to the stepper motor. In making a connection, you are going to make use of the port 1 along with the driver. So this ULN2003, it is a stepper motor driver IC, which is used to drive the current to this stepper motor. And in case of stepper motor, you are going to make use of the 6 wires. Among the 6 wires, the 4 wires are connected to this ULN 2003. Remaining 2 wires, they are shorted and connected to the plus 5 volt. So we'll start with the first program. The first program is write an assembly language program to rotate the stepper motor with the 4 steps clockwise continuously. So whenever it is a clockwise rotation, the first sequence will be the 99, then this 99 will be rotated to the right side, the next sequence is CC, next it is again rotated to the right side, next is 66, again it is rotated to the right side, the next sequence is 33. Since it is a continuous rotation, so these sequence will be send it through the infinite number of times. We'll start with the program. And here in case of a stepper motor, in order to send the sequence, you are going to make use of the port 1. The first sequence, it is 99, that will be copied to the port 1. So after sending the each sequence, so you should give some delay. For that, a subroutine program will be written, and this subroutine program will generate a delay in terms of the milliseconds. For that, I am going to use a call. A call stands for the absolute call. I am going to call a subroutine program called as a delay, so that the control of the program will be transferred here. So in case of the delay program, I make use of the 2 registers and I have taken some values, and this will be repeated, so that this, since you make use of the 2 registers, it will generate the delay in terms of the milliseconds. After outputting each sequence through the port 1, you should give some delay. So after that, again the control of the program will be transferred to the main program. Again you are going to send the second sequence. After sending the second sequence, again you are going to call the delay program. Next is third sequence, call the delay program. Next is fourth sequence, call the delay program. And then SJMP, short jump to the label again. That means this will be repeated for infinite number of times. So next is second program, write an assembly language program to rotate the stepper motor 4 steps in the anti-clockwise direction. That means you need to rotate the stepper motor in the anti-clockwise direction, and it is not the continuous way. After sending each sequence, you need to stop there itself. So here you are going to rotate the stepper motor in the anti-clockwise direction. The first sequence what you are going to consider is 33. This 33 will be copied to the, or it is moved to the port 1. After outputting each sequence, you should give some delay. So you want to call the delay program. And when this 33 will be rotated to the left side, the next sequence what you are going to get is 66. Again you want to call the delay program. Next is CC. Again you want to call the delay program. The next sequence is 99. Again you want to call the delay program. The same program, but you are not repeating this, because you are going to rotate the stepper motor in the anti-clockwise direction. And it's not a continuous rotation. Only there is a difference in the sequence what you are going to give. The third program is a switch is connected to the pin P2.7. Write an assembly language program to monitor the status of the switch. If the switch is equal to 1, stepper motor rotates in clockwise direction. If the switch is equal to 0, stepper motor rotates in anti-clockwise direction. The first 3 lines will be common. So initially you are going to set the bit P2.7 by using a set bit instruction. So based on this bit, you are going to decide whether the stepper motor is rotating in clockwise direction or in anti-clockwise direction. Initially you are going to take the first sequence, that is a 99, that will be copied to the register A. From the register A, you are going to copy that to the port 1, because you are going to send the sequence to the port 1 itself in case of the stepper motor. So then you are going to check whether this bit is equal to 0 or not. Jump if the bit is not set. The P2.7, if it is not equal to 1, then you are going to jump to a label CW. If it is not equal to 1 means, then the stepper motor will rotate in the anti-clockwise direction. It will, if this condition is satisfied, it will jump to the label CW. After that, RL. RL stands for the rotate left. You are going to rotate the contents of the accumulator to the left side by 1 times. That means the 99 sequence will be available in the accumulator, that you are going to rotate it to the left side. So when you rotate this to the left side, you are getting the sequence as 33. After that, you are going to call the delay, a call delay. After outputting every sequence, you are going to call the delay program, so that it will generate a delay in terms of the milliseconds. After that, the control of the program will be transferred to you. Then that value again you are going to copy to the port 1.
then SJMP turn. So the control of the program will be transferred here. Again, you are going to check whether this bit is equal to 1 or 0. If this bit is not set, means it will jump to a label CW. Then again, you are going to rotate the sequence. Now, in the accumulator, we have the sequence 33 that will be rotated to the left side by 1 pack. So, after that, you are going to get the sequence of 66. Then this process you want to repeat it. If suppose if the bit is equal to 1 means, then you want to rotate the stepper motor to the right side by clockwise by using the instruction RRA. After outputting every sequence, you want to call the delay, and this process you want to repeat it for infinite number of times.